Hi everyone, welcome to the another session on Automation Anywhere. So in the previous sessions, we have learnt about web recorders and smart recorders in Automation Anywhere. And in the today's session, we are going to learn about screen recorders in Automation Anywhere. So let's get started. And if you like the video, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also click on the bell icon to get the updates on the latest videos. So let's get started. First of all, let's see what is screen recorder and how we can use that in Automation Anywhere. So the screen recorders are used to automate tasks which involve mouse clicks, keyboard operations, or mouse movements. So I'm going to write it also. Used to automate tasks which involves mouse clicks, keyboard operations, and mouse movements. Let me correct it. Okay, so we are going to use screen recorders to automate tasks which involve mouse clicks, keyboard operations, and mouse movements. So by mouse movement, what I mean, screen recorder captures coordinates as well. Okay. So the screen recorder is going to capture the coordinates of your screen as well. And since it's going to capture the coordinates of your screen, you need to make sure that the screen resolution is same every time. Screen resolution should be same during the time of the recording and during the time when you are doing the execution of your task. Okay, so I'm going to write screen resolution should be same. Okay, and now that we are familiar with the screen recorder, now let's move ahead and let's see how we can work with screen recorders in Automation Anywhere. So for that, we are going to have two demo. First one with the desktop application and the second with the web application. So yes, the screen recorder works with both. Works with desktop and web applications. So let's look into the Automation Anywhere. So for that, let's move to Automation Anywhere, and you can start working with the screen recorder from this new button. So if you are going to click on new, you have this screen recorder button over here along with the smart recorder and web recorder which we have seen earlier. And if you want to use this record button to start the recording, make sure that the screen recorder is selected from the drop down. So if you click on drop down, you can see that screen recorder is selected, and since it is selected, if you click on this record, your recording will be started. So first demo which we are doing is with the desktop application. So what recording we are going to do? So the first demo which we will be having is the desktop application, where we will open the WordPad, we will type something over there, and we will save it. So this will be our first task which we are going to record with the help of screen recorders. So let's get started. So let's click on record. So once you click on record, the recording is started, and you can see from here the recording box is also available. And since the screen recorder is going to capture the mouse movement as well, so the mouse movement which I'm doing now, it's going to capture that as well. We can see that once the recording is over. So now let's start and let's hit the Windows and R keys. So let's do that. Windows and R key I enter, and from here I'm going to type WordPad. Let's hit the enter. So I have the WordPad with me. I can type something over here, maybe welcome to RPA. Okay, and let's save it. For saving, I'm going to use this Control plus S keys. So I have hit that Control S, and the window to save is open, and I'm going to give us name over here. So let's provide the name demo1. And let's hit the enter again to save this file. So the file is saved now. And now since my task is over, I'm going to stop the recording. For that, I'm going to go over here. And since I'm doing some mouse movement, so the screen recorder is going to capture that as well. So let's stop the recording. For that, let's press over here inside the stop. And I'm going to give a file name. So I'm going to give the file name as recording demo 1. So let's save it. And once you save this one, it will be available inside the my tasks. So this is the task which we created just now. Let's right click over here and let's click on edit. So this is the task which got created along with all the commands, and this the first command with us is the mouse move, the movement with of the mouse which I was doing. So the screen recorder captured that as well. So the next command with us is the keystrokes. So let's double click on that, and we have the insert keystrokes command. And you can see from the command as well in the left hand side, we have the insert keystrokes, insert mouse click, insert mouse move commands as well over here. So we can use these commands manually as well. But as of now, since we are using this screen recorder, so that's why we are not using that manually. That has been captured with the help of screen recorders. All these commands has been captured with the help of screen recorder. Okay, so let's see this command. This is the insert keystrokes. So the window which it selected is the currently active window. So currently active window at that time was this one. So it captured that. And what keystrokes we used? Firstly, we used Windows plus R keys. So this win down means that we pressed the Windows key. And this win up means we released the Windows key. And along with that, I also used R. So the keystrokes combination is this one. And here you can see we can add a delay as well. So let's edit that delay and let's give this 5000 milliseconds. That is the 5 seconds delay we will be having. And if you want to insert any variable, you can have variables from here. You can have special keystrokes from here as well if you want to use. So if you press Alt up, so it will be available over here. So as of now, it's not required. So let's remove it and let's save this one. So let's save this, and we have the other keystrokes as well. After that, we had typed WordPad and we pressed enter. So it got captured as well. Let's change the delay to 5000 milliseconds. And in a similar way, we mentioned welcome to RPA and we saved it with using Control plus S keys. So it got captured as well. Let's change the delay and let's save it. And after that, we gave the file name to demo 1 and we pressed enter. So we'll be doing the execution again. And since we have this demo 1 available with us, let me go over here, and since we have this demo 1 available over here, let's change the name. Let's keep the file name as demo 2 and press enter, and let's keep the delay again to 5000 milliseconds and let's save it. We have saved this one, and again at the end we moved our mouse, so it captured it as a mouse movement command. So this is the mouse movement command, insert mouse move. So these mouse movement commands is not required as of now. So we can disable this one, right click and disable this one. And we can disable this mouse movement as well. So let's click on disable. So we have our task ready with us, and let's do the execution and let's see the result what we have. So let's click on run. And so my execution is started, and it's going to enter the WordPad and it's going to type WordPad. So it's typing WordPad, and WordPad will get opened, and it's get opened, and it's typing welcome to RPA, and it will save the file as demo 2 since we had changed the name, and it typed demo 2. And my execution is over and it is successful. So if you see over here, you will have a demo 2 file with you, that which we created just now using the automation anywhere. Okay, so my first demo is over and it is successful. We had used screen recorders to type text in WordPad, and now let's move ahead and let's use this screen recorder for a web application. So for that, what I will be going to do, I will launch the Google Chrome, and I will search some keywords over there with the help of screen recorders. So let's do that as well. So for that, let's close this one and let's start the recording again. And now I'm going to use this new button. So click on the new button and Let's select this screen recorder from here and let's click it. And my recording is started and it's capturing my mouse movement as well. So let's hit the Windows plus R keys again. And we have this one, and let's launch Chrome from here. So for that I'm typing Chrome. So let's hit the Enter. So the Chrome will be launched now. And once the Chrome is launched, we can search something over here. Maybe let's search Wikipedia. And let's click on Enter. So now I have this Wikipedia page with me. So what we did, we launched the Chrome and we searched a keyword, we searched Wikipedia over there, and this is the Wikipedia page with us. And now let's stop the recording. My task is over. So let's move again to stop. It's capturing my mouse movement as well. So the recording can be stopped if you click on the stop button from here, and there is a shortcut as well. You can use Ctrl, Alt and S keys to stop the recording. So let's click on stop the recording, and now let's give the name. I'm going to give the name as screen recording demo 2, and let's hit on save. And my task got created. So this is the task which got created. Let's right click over here and let's click on edit. So again, this is the task which got created along with these commands. So again, this first mouse move and the last mouse move is not required. So you can disable this one. So I'm going to disable these mouse moves, and we have the keystrokes. So what we did, let's double click on that. So we have the insert keystrokes command again. So what we did, we hit the Windows plus R keys. So again, this win down means we are pressing the Windows button. Win up means we are releasing the Windows button along with this delay. So let's keep the delay as 5000 milliseconds. Let's save it. And what we did after that, we typed Chrome and we pressed enter. So it got created inside the keystrokes command. So let's edit the delays as well. And after that we searched Wikipedia. So what inside the keystrokes, this was the window, that is the new tab Google Chrome. In this window we searched Wikipedia and we pressed enter. So it got created inside this command as well. So let's save it. Now my task is ready and we are good to start the execution. So let's close this Chrome and let's start the execution from here. And my execution is started. It's going to type Chrome first of all. And now it's going to launch the Chrome. And in the Chrome, it's going to search the Wikipedia. And search the Wikipedia inside the Chrome. So what we did, we had seen two tasks. First we did the screen recording with the desktop application, and in the second demo we did the screen recording with the web application. So in this way you can use screen recording in your application as well. And now if you compare this web recorder, smart recorder and screen recorder, you can observe that the screen recorder is very simple out of these recording techniques. And since it is simple, it is very much prone to error as well, since it is dependent on the resolution. It is capturing the hard-coded values. So that's why it is much more prone to error. So I'm going to write it over here as well. Simple of all the recorders and much prone to error. Okay, so that's all for this session. You can try to use screen recorders in your project as well. And if you have any query, please put in the comment section below and I will try to solve your queries. Okay, that's all for this session. Thank you. Have a nice day.